Hi, I'm Gia Peppers here with the super dope and ultra talented artists Doechii and Baby Tate, two of my absolute faves. And today we're having a conversation around Black women and mental health inspired by the Netflix animated film, Wendell and Wild. Wendell and Wild is the story of a troubled teen named Kat who is haunted by her past and must confront her personal demons played by comedy icons Key and Peele to start a new life in her old hometown.
We are Wendell
and Wild,
your personal demons.
This film is directed by visionary filmmaker Henry Selick, who brought us classics like The Nightmare Before Christmas and Coraline. And it's also co-written and produced by Jordan Peele himself. Wendell and Wild is playing right now on Netflix. We brought these women together because Afropunk music is at the heart of the film. It ties Kat to her family bonds and expresses her individuality. Both Doechii and Baby Tate embody that every single day in their artistry, in their music, in their social medias, and everything they do. And big shout out to Doechii, whose song I Told Him is featured in the trailer. Congrats, girl.
Thank you.
We thought it would be so great to have this conversation around grief, trauma, and confronting personal demons to empower us to be the best version of ourselves. So let's get right into it. Y'all ready, ladies?
Yeah.
Okay, thank y'all so much for being here. What did you guys think of the movie? Like, I was blown away.
It was so good. I really enjoyed the animation. I enjoyed the story, the fact that the lead is a young Black girl, you know? So it just was really great. It was super funny, too.
I thought it was, like, absolutely phenomenal, so creative. It was like this whole universe, and it puts you in this world. And as a child, if I were to watch that as a kid, I would feel so immersed in the experience.
I'm so excited to have this conversation with you all today, because in Wendell and Wild, it's all about the reality of how we deal with our personal demons. Like, they don't just get smaller as you get older. So Kat's personal demons are playful and mischievous, and they play tricks on Kat to manipulate her into serving their needs. So how would you guys describe the relationship you have with your own personal demons? Do they sometimes play mind games on you? Do you have names for them? Tell me about your personal relationships with those inner demons.
For me, I think my relationship with my, like, demons is just, like, knowing that they're there and not trying to just, like, push them to the side, but trying to let them know who's in charge of this spirit and this soul and this mind. You might be here, but, like, you working for me, not the other way around.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And yeah.
Same as Tate. Like, I recognize my shadow self and my demons as something that I work with. Now, I kind of tell them what to do. And we really cool now. Like, if anything, I used to be, like, really ashamed. Like, why do I even have a dark side? Like, that shouldn't be a thing. It should be not my state 24/7. Then I realized that, like, my shadow side and my demons can actually help me see myself in a more human way. Mm-hmm. And I kind of forgave myself and them. And now we work together. Like,
exactly. We
cool, but not too much.
Know your place. Know your role.
Know your role.
Yeah.
Yeah, because sometimes I feel like our demons, and I like to say, like, our personal traumas and griefs, they shape us into who we are. Pain teaches you where light, like, leads you. Pain teaches you.
Yes.
What do you think was maybe one of the biggest moments of your life that might have been the most painful that really shaped you into being who you are today?
If I'm talking about the industry, like, coming up in the underground scene, I went through a lot of, like, different traumatic situations that I feel like if I attach myself too much to them or identify too much with those traumatic experiences, it could make me really bitter. Mm-hmm. But that's an example of, like, something happening to you, you recognizing that it happened, you forgiving yourself for allowing it to happen, and you move on. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
I feel like a lot of times we take the things that happen to us and we, like, make that our personality trait.
Right.
Like, if you harp too much on those, they really do make you bitter.
And that's where we meet Kat. You know, she's bitter, she's angry,
she's mad at the world.
Sad she lost her parents.
I really, really need to talk to you.
The grief alone of that situation. Mm-hmm. I love that this movie really addresses it. I was like, oh, okay.
We're getting deep.
We're going deep. And speaking of going deep, you know, what are some of the things that your inner demons might say to hurt, mislead, or disempower you? Like, what are some of those thoughts? And you know, that's not me talking. That's someone else.
I think a lot of them are birthed outside of me. It's like stuff that other people said that like caught on to something in me, and it started to make me think, like, was they right? Am I overweight?
No.
Am I untalented? No. Like, mm-hmm. And I know that these things are not true, but sometimes they just creep in and allow you to, like, doubt yourself.
All the negativity that may come from an outward force, if you identify with that, the second you identify with anything positive or negative, you become that. Mm-hmm. And I was thinking about the scene where Kat was saying that you don't want to be my friend because mm-hmm. everybody around me dies.
I don't do friends, Raul. Bad things happen to people I'm close to.
So she believed that mm-hmm. this one negative thing that happened to her, that she is just an attraction of negative energy. Mm-hmm. So it's about constantly identifying with the positive and true aspects of yourself versus the untrue negative aspects that mm-hmm. other people try to project onto you.
Yeah. Ooh, y'all are preaching. Because I see how people treat Black women on the mm-hmm. internet, but especially Black women in music.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I can only imagine that you all have created methods to just block it out, because you can't turn off every comment.
Yeah.
But what are some of the things that you do, like, if you ever get in a spiral of social madness, like, what are some of the things that you do to remind yourself of who you are?
I still, you know, have moments where I'm like, you know what? I'm finna get petty with you. You wanna go there? I wanna go too. How far is the trip? How much it costs?
Mm-hmm. How much?
But it might be a little healthy, a little bit.
I think
bit.
It is.
Because sometimes you really do need to get it out.
Yeah.
Because there is so much, like, every other day is I'm battling allegations after mm-hmm. allegation. People talking about me doing this and doing that. Mm-hmm. And it just builds up to the point where it's like, how peaceful can I be?
And pretending that, I'm gonna take these shoes off, period.
Yeah.
Pretending that it doesn't bother you
right.
will drive you crazy. I think it's healthy sometimes. You know, a respectful clap back is not wrong.
Yeah.
I gotta let you know right now, that hurt my feelings. Mm. Mm-hmm. And I don't like that. And
don't
what you said isn't
that.
True. And this is what I'm clearing up.
Period.
But then you wanna be careful because you don't wanna become a slave to, like, over explaining yourself.
Yes.
Sometimes I'll even call my mom and be like, Mom, what you think about that? And she'll be in the comments like,
shout out to mamas everywhere. Thank you.
But not too much. It won't ruin our day. We'll go have dinner, mm-hmm. do something, drink a glass of wine, and move on.
I love your song, I Am, of course. It's
Thank
literally
you.
An affirmation. Mm-hmm. Like, you can journal to it. That's mm-hmm. how many affirmations are in it. Do you play that when you have, like, negative moments? Like, do you be like, let me put on my song because I'm tripping right now? And if not, what affirmations are you saying to yourself? Same for you, Doechii. What are your affirmations that you meet any negative voices with?
I literally have to log out, turn the phone off, and just remind myself, this does not define me. These people don't know me.
Right.
That's really what it is. These people don't know me. Like, if they see me on the street, they wouldn't know a thing.
Mm. Right.
And if they see me on the street, they wouldn't say what they just said.
I was about to say that, too.
They would not say that.
Is anybody about to say it to your face?
Okay. So for me, I just have to remind myself of that.
Part of my affirmations is constantly bringing myself into the present moment. Like, despite what's going on and what people are saying, why am I doing this? Mm-hmm. I'm doing what I love. Mm-hmm. I am fed. I am healthy. I am wealthy. I am rich.
I am net.
Hey. Hello? My family is safe. Like, then I'll just be like, it's not even that serious to be upset over. Mm-hmm. I have an actual, like, affirmation, like, it's 2 pages long, and mm-hmm. I say these affirmations. I've been saying them since, like, 2020.
Do you mind give us an example of one of the affirmations you say?
Absolutely. I no longer fear the superstitions of the race, meaning, like, everybody is, like, on this pace. Like, I gotta post every day. Mm-hmm. I gotta do this. There's this superstition of some type of race that we're all running, or we all are competing with each other or whatever. But I always detach, and I detach from the superstitions of a race.
I love that. Because when you think about superstitions, they're made up.
They're made up. It's an illusion.
Yeah.
Instagram wasn't even around 10 years ago.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, and the fact that it plays so much on our mental mm-hmm. right now, that's what I have to remind myself. Like, girl, this is not real. Conversely, what does it look like for you to be in a healthy relationship with those feelings? We were just talking about sometimes you do need to clap back. Sometimes mm-hmm. you do need to stand up for yourself.
You're talking about the relationship with my demons?
Yes.
I think that sometimes they give me, like, that fire, that mm-hmm. twang, that edge that I need sometimes. Like, the fire that I would need if somebody said something about my body that made me uncomfortable, or somebody did something to me that may have made me feel uncomfortable or sexually assaulted. Mm-hmm. It gives me the fire to say something mm-hmm. out loud and check somebody. When I'm feeling down, I kind of have to use that aggression and that anger to pull myself out of a sad place. It gives me the power when I hop on a track like crazy and I can yell and go crazy.
I love getting a battery put in my back.
Mm.
Oh, I love it. That'd be like, oh, you woke up the wrong one
mm-hmm.
today. Because the demons was asleep. I had them on mm-hmm. NyQuil. Mm-hmm. You know, like, they was knocked out and you just woke up the wrong ones.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't even know the power that
Ooh, baby. Yeah. Wait, just watch. Mm-hmm. Just watch. Sometimes you gotta get out that bubble.
Period.
Sometimes you gotta get down in the dirt. Yeah. Get nitty and gritty.
Yeah.
Get them nails dirty. Mm-hmm.
That's giving the intro. Like, whatever song that is coming from that.
Right. No, that was
the intro to a very fire song. I just want you to know.
Now, we all have demons, but we all have positive spirits within us, too, that we've been talking about. When you all do live in your light, what are some of the positive forces that keep you going?
For me, it's love. Ooh. Like, I feel like that's so basic. But love is really amazing. Love from friends, from, like, the people you work with, from, you know, romantic love, family. Like, it just feels so good, and it reminds you, like, I have a purpose here. Mm-hmm. People love me. Mm-hmm. And being free to do, like, whatever you want to do. This is our own simulation that we're creating. Like, I can literally do anything. Mm-hmm. And, you know, just reminding yourself of the fact that the limit does not exist.
The limit does not exist.
The limit does not exist. That's the realest thing Katie Heron ever said in her life. Mm-hmm.
For me, it's shamelessness.
Ooh.
Like, I don't want to ever feel ashamed of anything I do. Or who I am, I think that's what I'm trying to say.
That's something I really love about you. Like, you really are just like, I'm me. And if you don't like it, okay. If you do, great.
You too.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Honestly, you. The way that you walk in this world frees other Black women.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And, like, you all matter so much mm-hmm. to the fabric of, forget music.
Yeah.
Like, just being representatives of Black girls who said, I'm going to be free mm-hmm. every single day. I'm going to choose to be free. Like, I'm going to be free to wear this wig. I'm going to be free to wear no wig. I'm going to be free to wear these bangs or not. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. I think that's mm-hmm. so powerful. And so just... Yes, Wendell and Wild, but also thank y'all for real, because you are freeing little Black girls every day.
Thank
so.
You. You're so
thank
welcome.
Thank you.
Okay, now let's get into a clip. We're going to get into the clip of Raul in the tower and spray painting the mural. Tattoo Bessie is a trans boy named Raul. When we first meet him, he's isolated from all the other students. We soon learn that he spends his time alone creating beautiful large-scale murals, which, shout out to his mama, let him do that on the roof.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How does your creativity play in processing your own emotions and owning your narrative?
I started making music when I was 13, and a lot of the reason was because I needed to express myself. I felt like I couldn't really say the things that I wanted to say, like necessarily to my mom or to the boy I liked at school or to the teachers that were like getting on my nerves. And so I would express it in my music, and I still do that to this day. And I really appreciate when other people tell you, like, your song brought mm-hmm. me through this mm-hmm. or like, you don't know what this song meant for me. It's like, mm-hmm. dang, I actually do though. Cause it meant that for
me. Similar to Tate, my music is just like, I've always loved documenting myself. And music is kind of like taking a picture mm-hmm. for me. It's like when I make a song, I can freeze time. Like, this was a moment that I felt this way, that happened, and that's me freezing time and whatever lesson or whatever I'm talking about.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Also, y'all both have, like, everything you do is just viral, and I love to watch it. But your songs, especially I Am and Persuasive, out of here. So can you tell me about the stories and where you guys were when you wrote those songs in particular? Because both of them are very empowering. Were you in a moment where you felt like you needed to get it out? And if so, was there a catalyst or a story behind why you needed to say it to yourself?
Yeah, absolutely. For I Am, it was peak pandemic.
Yeah, yeah.
I was going through it, like, emotionally. It was just, like, a lot of low vibrations in the house. I was trying to get myself out of it. Yeah. And so I wanted to create some affirmations for myself that I could say. And I think when you create, like, things that rhyme and, like, are in a chant form, it's just, like, easier to remember them, easier to, like, get them in your spirit. Yeah. And so I was just doing that. I wrote them down in my notes, and I just started saying them. And I was like, you know what? I think it would sound cool in a song.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, that's where I Am came from, just, like, needing my own affirmations.
With Persuasive, I just really wanted to replicate this feeling of, like, when you're, like, with your friends. Okay, so, like, majority of my friends are gay.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know if this is just a gay thing or a LGBTQ thing, but when we link up, we watch Beyonce performances and we laugh and we play games and like it just feels like family and fashion and love and we show each other our work that we've been working on and we just like have a ball and we dance and whatever. And I wanted Persuasive to feel like that.
There is so much joy that comes from that song. Okay, we're gonna get into another clip, ladies. This is from the Redemption Chamber, so let's check it out.
Time to face your past. Ready?
I love this scene so much. It touches on so much, from how corrupt the foster care system is, to the school-to-prison pipeline, to just the chance that young Black girls are not often afforded to be heard and to be understood. But what I really appreciated about this scene was the fact that I think a lot of times our trauma, we try to bury it and we try to act like it doesn't exist. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And until you like sit there and confront that, it will never go away.
Go on, own your memories.
You've tortured me for years. But you made me a survivor. And crazy powerful. I'm in control of my life now. Not you.
Oh my God.
So many things. What just came up for y'all when y'all were watching that?
I think what stood out to me was how she was acknowledging that her demon held her back, but also made her strong. Mm-hmm. She said, but you made me strong. That really touched me because it's like, in a weird way, her demon was trying to be so powerful to get her attention. Mm-hmm. And she didn't want to look for so long. Mm-hmm. Like, you don't want to look at that. You don't want to acknowledge that trauma, that pain, but it wants to be seen. It wants to be heard so badly.
When I watched that scene, like, I don't know. I mean, we talked about the pandemic. Mm-hmm. I remember being in my room and just being like so depressed and tired. Like, why is it this hard though? Like, should it not be this hard? But then I realized that, like, I was running from a lot of trauma that I didn't realize was there because I was so used to being on the move, being hosting things, that I wasn't sitting with it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so, like, for me, that scene represents sitting with your trauma.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And like taking it brick by brick, not out of who you are, because it's still a foundational part of who you are, but remembering that, like, it's not only who you are.
I recently started taking therapy. I think that everyone should. And a thing that you just said about, like, taking everything out brick by brick, I like to think of it as, like, you're taking the brick out and then you're realizing that this is clay. And, like, I can mold this into something else. It's not gonna be gone, but it doesn't have to be this like solid thing that's like pressing in on me.
In Wendell and Wild, Sister Helly, played by the incredible Angela Bassett. I mean, I can listen to her talk all day. She's perfect. Yeah. But she helps Kat through her guilt. Obviously, we see her literally talk her through it. Can you share a time when someone helped you when you needed it most? And talk about why it's so important for you to be able to turn to others for support in those really dark moments.
A time where I got support that I needed was from you. Yeah. Sorry.
You're about to make me cry.
I'm about to cry as well. There was this time where I was going through it on the internet. I was getting ate up real, real, real bad. And no one reached out to me. And though, you were the only person that did. And I just wanted to tell you that I really appreciate you for that. And I really see you as like a sister. I'm so sorry.
Don't be sorry. We done now. We done
And I love you.
I love you too.
I love the spirit that you are. And I needed that. I needed that from you. And it just reminded me that, like, you know, people do love you. You just gotta find the ones that do.
I love you.
I love you too.
I hate you for making me.
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
This is super hurt for me.
But I really do.
Wow.
That's so beautiful.
Yeah.
I'm so happy that I was able to have this conversation with you two beautiful human beings. Thank you so much, Doechii. Thank you so much, Baby Tate, for being here.
Thank you.
Oh, y'all had a good time.
Yeah.
Sorry that we cried. but thank you for being vulnerable, because I know so many people will be seen through this conversation. So just thank y'all so much for being here. And thank you all for watching this. We hope you loved it as much as we did. Catch Wendell and Wild, starring Keegan-Michael Key, Jordan Peele, Lyric Ross, Angela Bassett, James Hong, and Ving Rhames, now playing on Netflix.